Video will talk about all the fell terriers, so starting from Lakeland to Border to White Fell Terrier to Black Fell Terrier as this little guy, also to the German Fell Terriers such as the German Hunt Terrier, also known as the German Yacht, and also it's a more relaxed stable mate. Voluntary. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Give a subscribe if you do. Bye bye. So another candidate would be the Working Lakeland Terrier. The Working Lakeland Terrier is a breed very close to the Lakeland Terrier that is a show version, but with less exaggerated features, less Fox Terrier influences, and looks a lot more like a long-haired Pattedale Terrier. The dog on the leash here is a Black Fell Terrier, smooth-coated, also known as Pattedale Terrier. Oi, oi. Oh. Working Lakelands are known to be hard workers, good coat at the deck stem, very good for earthwork, will confront the quarry, are not excessive barkers, quite silent, strong type of working dogs. At the current state, they are far less common than they once were, and I think a lot of the working Lakelands have been either assimilated or switched or taken over in this case by the Pattedale Terrier, which has similar properties but also is worked and evolved more and comes in different coats depending on the terrain. Working Border Terriers are often very close in resemblance to the show versions. I think the Border Terrier has not changed that much, being a show dog now. Some are still being worked, but this type of terrier has a broken coat, a very short, strong skull, but lately, especially show versions, they have been bred to look bigger than they shoot as a traditional working dog. That made a big skull, but also a bigger chest that was not able to go into the narrow fox tent anymore. The same problem that Lakeland has, that the Border Terrier is now less known as being a hunting dog. Only a few enthusiasts still keep them, and most of their work is now being done by Pattedale Terriers. This is Estacado, my smooth-coated Pattedale Terrier on the leash, and also the Pattedale Terrier comes in a broken coat variety. Like the Border Terrier, next to smooth, as you see here, this Pattedale Terrier, and the long hair that looks more like a Black Lakeland. So these terriers are all similar in attributes and have their own merits. The good thing is that a lot of Border Terriers are still being used if they are worked. So for example, crossbred to Pattedale Terriers, and also some Pattedale Terrier blood finds its way into Border Terrier lines, and this is a good thing. Often a Border Terrier brings a very strong head, which is a confrontational type of terrier. Also, they are very courageous, strong and silent. So this is like a miniature catch dog. Very good for earthwork if you have a good working one. Next to the Black Fell Terrier, example that you see here as being a Pattedale Terrier, there's also a White Fell Terrier. White Fell Terriers have similar attributes, they're also being used to catch foxes, but are a little bit less confrontational and more of a baying type of Fell Terrier. So they go and confront the foxes and badgers if needed, but they also physically, but they stay out of harm's way a little bit more, and that way they can be kept for multiple hunts instead of recuperation after some hard hunts where they have been damaged themselves as well, against fox, but especially badger. This white fell terrier has a more of a baying type of style, so it will bay, bark at its prey, also attack it and then jump back again, so more taunting. Only when it can have a very good grip, it will go all in. These dogs are still courageous, but are a little bit less devastating to themselves, because they don't seek that confrontational style. They try to keep out of harm's way if possible, but still go in. Examples of white fell terriers are the Jack Russell and also Parson Russells that are now sometimes still being hunted, especially Parson Russells are. And the new phenomenon is the Bull Russell, which is a cross between a working fell, so for example a Parson Russell, and also some added blood of Bull Terrier lines, especially miniature Bull Terrier, because they want to keep the size a little bit down. Sometimes the Bull Terrier is watered down to 12.5 or 25%, but very often you also see it 25% to keep the properties of the Bull. The reason for this cross is that they want to get more courage and more power, and holding capabilities of the Bull Terrier combined with still the baying, taunting type of White Fell Terrier, so that you have a dog that you can work almost every day of the week, even on hard quarry, because it won't be totally destroyed by its opponent and don't take too much damage, because it is not that out and out confrontational as, for example, a Pretterdale Terrier, that's a dog that you see here on the leash, often is. Then, in many people's view, the Elite Ur Terrier, the Black Fell Terrier. Black Fell Terriers come in different shapes and sizes, also different coats. So long hairs, rough coated, and also smooth coated like this one. And the prime example of the Black Fell Terrier is the Pretterdale Terrier. Contrary to its name, not all Pretterdale Terriers are black. Most are, however, because black is also quite a dominant color. Benefit of a black dog is that they can release the heat when they are below ground. They're very efficient because of that color, and they don't have a lot to suffer from the heat outside in the field, because they are developed to work underground. Very good dog on badger, foxes. Also, this type of dog is very good at confronting it. It's a silent type of dog. Despite the size, they are classified as strong dogs. The drawback is that they are that confrontational that they often suffer a lot of damage. And once they are damaged, they need some time to heal up again. Whereas a less confrontational style dog, for example White Fell Terrier or Bull Russell especially, could be hunted more days, in theory at least. The benefit of a catch dog type of terrier is that the quarry has a hard time to escape. Also, they will stay till dark. They are very strong type of dogs, and also very very good workers. The future of the Pretterdale Terrier is that it is a still evolving breed. Not that it's not good enough, but they, like many working breeds, they keep looking to improve upon it. And also there are mixed versions sometimes, because for example one hunter likes a dog that's very confrontational, very hard. Another likes a dog that has a little bit more baying into it, so more of a mixed type Pretterdale. Crosses are often seen are crosses with Border Terrier, working Lakeland. Sometimes a little bit of Bull and Terrier breeds are infused, especially Staffordshire Bull Terrier of working lines or American Pitbull Terrier. But most of the characteristics are already set into the Pretterdale Terrier as is. Nee, nee. Hoi, hoi. Go back. So, that being said, Pretterdale Terrier has a lot of Terrier influence compared to Staffordshire Bull Terrier or American Pit Bull Terrier, and a lot of bull influences as compared to, for example, a Lakeland or a Whitefield Terrier, but still not as much as a bull has, as for example a Border Terrier has. So we discussed some terriers really bred for earthwork, and now we also discuss the Jagd Terrier, the German Jagd Terrier or German Hunting Terrier, which is a breed developed as a jack of all trades. But this is a dog that can be used on badger and foxes as a more of a baying, aggressive type of style, instead of just all out like a Pettadil Terrier. All out confrontation of these dogs are a way to keep out of harm's way if possible. On the other hand, they are extremely courageous and they're also very persistent. These types of dogs have great stamina, quite a good nose, especially for a terrier. They're also used above ground, especially on the black quarry. So for example, wild hogs, and can chase them. They are quite quarrelsome. They will fight among each other a lot more than, for example, Pettadil Terriers in general. And they come in three coats as well. So the long head, rough coat that was originally bred, and also now you have a smooth coated Jagd Terrier and a broken coated sometimes. But often you see the long head and sometimes the smooth coated, not many times the intermediate broken coated types. The German Hunting Terrier is a dog that can do everything, but it's not a dog that excels at everything. However, it is a breed that has been very well selected out of a good specimen, and they developed it as a breed that is a very good hunting terrier, perhaps the best, because it can do everything. However, there are some genetic problems into the breed, especially because of the inbreeding that was so that hard, and there were some troubles because they had such a limited gene pool after some decreases in the Jagd Terrier population by, for example, wars that were fought, and also other problems because they only selected the black and tan dogs to work with instead of the other colorations. This has led to different other breeds, which I will come back later, but most notably the Westfalen Terrier and Heide Terrier, both also German breeds. So the Westfalen Terrier is like a more family oriented and a little bit healthier Jagd Terrier. That was the base. So you get a dog that is less aggressive, especially to its owner, less nervous as well, so it could be kept in house if needed. Jagd Terrier is very hard to keep in house because it's overly active constantly, and not a nice thing to have in many a house. The Westfalen Terrier is a little bit more laid back. They crossed in some Fox Terrier blood especially to make it an easier type of dog, and has a more even temperament. The Westfalen Terrier is a breed that has many of the benefits of the Jagd Terrier with a little bit less of its drawbacks, and it's an upcoming breed. Also, because it is less quarrelsome among each other, it would be easier to use them in pack hunting, and could also, as such, have a bigger role in hawk hunting. That being said, still the German Jagd Terrier is often used a lot more than the Westfalen Terrier, which is an upcoming terrier breed. Westfalen Terrier can also be used underground, like the German Hunting Terrier, has also similar size, often German Hunting Terriers, and Westfalen Terrier are a little bit on the bigger side for working underground, but it's more of a jack of all trades type of dog.